Stream should be up now. I hope the quality of the stream is okay. I'm gonna use the phone actually to keep an eye on it. Okay, we're here. Can I see how many viewers are here? Well, it's empty here so far, according to my phone. I'm gonna get started in a moment. Okay, I will keep an eye on the chat. Just checking that everything's working as intended. Okay, stream quality seems okay. And let me just show this real quick. So that this stream is for the Dark Mud, open source stealth game, kind of based on the inspiration of the Thief series from the mid 90s, which had a few successors then afterwards. Anyhow, it's not in ports yet, but if you wanna run it in the meantime before it's imported, because I'm still trying to figure a few things out. There was a hotfix released, but only apparently via the binary form, not as like a source code package. So that's what I'm still trying to figure out. In the meantime, you can go here to the OpenBSD WIP, and here's the full address, Dreammaster Games, the Dark Mod. And you can use this, you can pull this and use that to build the 2.07 version of the game. That's without the hotfix, so the newer AMD drivers apparently have some problems, which I'm noticing on my desktop, which has some weird flickering there. So, that said, let's get started. I did a small test stream previously. And that was without the mic, but now the mic should be working. Let me know if there's any issues. I'll put it in the chat. Okay. That said, I'm gonna get started now, and I tried this already earlier, This is running on the Skylake, and I want to do a little bit of the training mission and then like the first actual mission. So the game has this, it's an i7 Skylake. The game has this thing that it reboots itself when you pick a different mission. Not sure if that is how it's intended, but that's how it works. So here it says mission run a new job, but I want to do training mission, so I need to do this first. So I do this, and then it does the whole thing again and restarts itself, which is otherwise not really an issue. So training mission is what it says now. Here's some settings where you can configure the key bindings and the graphic detail, but I'm leaving this alone for now. I customized the keys a little bit for my cool Mac keyboard layout. So, training mission, and we just pick start this mission. I'll show later how you can download more missions from inside the game. Okay, so here's the mission description. Just press escape to quit the mission. By the way, escape during the intro video also exits it, and you don't continue to the mission then, which is not really applicable to this one, but to the other ones, which have a little video at the beginning. Took me a little while to figure it out. Press the mouse button one instead. So we'll start the mission. But I'm not going to spend a lot of time here. It's just as a refresher. I guess it should be pretty similar to the Thief games, with the light gem in the middle and everything. Yeah, you're admiring the loading screen for the mission here. I've been looking today a little bit into if I can get a recent checkout from the Subversion repository, but there's an issue with that I can't resolve so far with Minisip, where it doesn't build it, and I need to build it with the bundled and link it because we don't have it in ports. So yeah, but here we go. Frop. I don't know what frop is supposed to mean, but the right mouse button is frop, and it's, I guess, interacting with the game. And you go here, and you can see it. I'm just gonna check that this looks okay. Okay, it does. And you can use the next previous weapon mode to turn the pages, the attack button to get out of it. I did the stealth part the other day. Keys and lockpicks sounds like something worth it. The item, it changed the key layout again. Why does it do this? I'm not sure why it does this, but it keeps changing my key layout. Strafe right is this. Weird. Oh well. Weapons. This here and stored some of it. I don't really get it. What's going on here? Lantern, I think, should maybe be this and compass this. Hi, Canadian Brian. I'm sorry that I'm spending a bunch of time in the menus, but I'm not sure why it keeps changing my button layout. Anyhow. So, now that seems better. Right. Left. Lean forward. I love it that there's even a lean forward button. Can find lockpicks in the lock chest. Pick up the key from the table and press use or throw on the chest with the key in your inventory. The keys here is highlighted. Picked it up with right mouse button. Here's the chest. Key unlocked it. Here's the lockpicks. Mastery of lockpicks is essential if you are to complete the mini missions. For each open door, there's a key to lock it if you wish to pick it again. There are two types of lockpicks, triangle and snake. To begin, you must have the correct lockpick selected. Interesting. Close enough, hold the use key. Clicks are random, and there's a brief period of silence in the panel. Begin again. This, to be successful, you must release the use key at the start of that silence. If you hit the attack key at the wrong... If you hit it at the wrong time, there's a dull fail sound and the pattern begins again. Goal is to learn the sequence of clicks so that you can anticipate when it will end. Some locks are more difficult than others and have multiple pins. This is different from the original Thief. You can make lockpicking harder or easier in the settings menu by adjusting how much silence there is between each pattern. More silence, the easier it is to react in time. Setting lockpicking to auto will make locks open automatically after. Okay, well, let's give this a try. Not guaranteeing nothing. Okay, so I picked the lockpick. How do I use? Thank you, Brainerd. That was all I needed to know. Use inventory items. Enter. Okay. Do I need to pick the different one? I'm not going to waste too much time on it though, but I think this is one thing that I need to actually learn. Move close enough to highlight the door. Hold the use key. You'll start to hear a sequence of clicks and see the door handle and jiggle in sync. Okay, the clicks are a random pattern. At the end of the pattern is a brief period of silence, then the pattern will begin again. Successful, you must release the use key at the start of that silence. Okay, snake lockpick. There's a little red coloring behind it if I use the snake lockpick. Use the triangle lockpick. This one's a little more advanced, as they say. Do I need to pick the other one now? Okay. Okay, that's enough. I think I'm gonna start the real mission now. Okay, so we need to restart it here. We quit the mission, and then the game will restart after we select the new job mission. So this is the one, and then it says install mission. It's already in there, but I guess install just switches the game to it. And then it says the game will be restarted now. Then it does a bunch of things, opens the window again, and the main menu is here, but now it says mission one, a new job. So there will be an intro video with some narration. And in that intro video, if you hit escape, it's gonna go back to the menu here and not start the mission. Don't get that wrong. Press mouse button one instead. do quite a bit of branding there. But now let's let him talk.
I go by many names in this city. Outlaw, rogue, thief. The few people who know me call me Corbin. My job is to acquire valuable items for the rich. Sounds easy. But these items are usually owned by someone already. Someone who doesn't want to part with them. Luckily, I'm quite good at what I do. Tonight I'm meeting someone who wants to hire me for a job. I don't know the details yet, but an associate of mine has vouched for him, and the message managed to pique my interest. I'm supposed to meet my contact in a courtyard south of Canterbury Tavern. Canterbury is popular with wealthy travelers, and it just so happens that a Lord Rothwick is staying there tonight. I'm told he has a purse full of very expensive rubies with him. I've decided to arrive in the area a little early and engage in a bit of burglary. A tavern won't have the same level of security as a private estate, and it shouldn't be too difficult to find what room Lord Rothwick is in. The guest names are in the registry. I can help myself to that purse and still meet my contact in the courtyard on time. Not bad for a night's work. I've booked a room near the tavern. The sun is down, my gear is ready, and the city awaits. It's time to begin.
Okay, I'm not sure how long the video without the narration continues. After this, let's just advance if it doesn't on its own. It does. Oh well. Okay, so here's a couple of difficulties. It seems to be like it was designed for Thief, that the objectives actually change with the difficulty level. You see the number of loot changes when it gets to veteran, but I think I'll go with normal because I'm not really new to stealth, but I'm not a pro by any means. Objectives: find your way to Canterbury Tavern. Get inside. Find loot worth at least 400 gold pieces, which is optional. Meet your contact in the southeast corner of Royston Court. And now we can buy equipment. So we have some starting gear here. You can see the description. Compass, hooded lantern, it's waterproof, spyglass. Short sword. When things go wrong, lockpicks, blackjack. Blackjack is very important. And then here, I guess I do have bow and arrow, and they just don't list it here. I have 60 gold, and I think I would want a few water arrows. Broadhead and noisemaker. Or no, rather moss arrow. One of these. Okay, let's keep the rest of the money for now and start the mission. The loading screen takes a while to load the level.
the back alleys of Bridgeport. You can get almost anywhere unseen, if you know your way through the maze.
Do we have a map? What's the button for the map? I don't think we do have one. I think you need to buy it. Cycle maps. Apparently we don't have that. So nothing here. We can go through items, lockpick, snake lock, lantern, spyglass, compass. I don't even have a bow and arrow apparently. So I guess I bought those for nothing. So is there anything up? So, I guess I need to find my way to the tavern. So here you see to climb on these things. It's not the same as the... What? Did the buttons get messed up again? Okay. Strafe right will be... S. Right. T. This here will be F. Yeah. Backward will be. This door's just painted on, apparently. Can I talk to this person? Hello. Is there a button for talking? I guess the person's just sitting there in a corner. I'm crouched now. Can't go in here either. I'll just drop down here.
I can probably get up on that pipe if I can find something to stack.
This door is not far. Okay, if I stack a few things, I can get up, but where? On that pipe? I guess so. A few things around here. Let's see if I can take any of these. I can take this here. I can carry some of the other things here. Hey, come on. The carrying seems a little... Let's try that again. Okay, sometimes I need to use space to move forward. I'm not sneaking right now. I could like this with control. Is this here the tavern?
The city watch makes the main streets a lot riskier. Even regular citizens might raise a hue and cry if they see someone dressed like me.
So the question is, how do I progress from here? I can drop down to here. Can I scale along here on the left? That seems to be safer. That seems a little risky to jump over there. I would probably also make a bunch of noise. Okay, so they're moving. Gotta drop down here. Okay. Let's try not to drop on a hard surface. I'll save. Visible up here. There's nothing here that I would want. Let's get out of here. We can. Okay, that went
Drop
wrong.
That weapon! Don't move! You think you're pretty smart, huh?
Do I have anything?
Yeah! Is that all you've got? Take this! Yeah! Ow! Take this!
Weapon!
Ow!
Don't
move!
I'm not much of a fighter. In this game, I'm more of a sneaker. Okay, so I used a number of keys to pick weapons. F9 would be quick load. Okay, so I'm back here. I did not win. No. I was just... I need to keep an eye out for those guards. They're gonna come back at some point. I don't really know yet. Oh, this is laid out. Oh, here are the streets. There's a flickering light that's kind of inviting. The darkness is giving me a little cover. It's a little too bright here. Guy doesn't come all the way over here. I'm a little bit without cover. Maybe over here I'll be better protected from the guards. It's the kind of game where you end up saving all the time. Danger. Electrification. What? Electrification? What's with this? Hello, Solen. I'm just trying to figure out this game. Can't climb over this. Can't go through here. This is pretty much an impasse. It's just a way for me. I guess a little place where I can hide out. Let's consider it. Let's treat it as such. There's a guard coming again. But when I peek around the corners like this, I shouldn't be too visible. I'm waiting for the guard to go back. There, yes, and he's gonna go back on his patrol. So he's first gonna go right. The other guy's coming back. They're going over there. The other guard's still to the right, which I don't like. I'm crouching. I'm not tiny. I could take the guards out with a blackjack, of course. I'm crouching, yes. I can hide here while they go past me. This is a very good hiding spot. There you can see the guard. Here's one of them. Here's the blackjack. Should we try taking out one of the guards? The blackjack. Where's the other guard? Oh. Wait, this one's coming, just coming back. Yeah, this game is not really good for your knees. If you have bad knees, then be careful when playing it. Let's just try this for once, even if we're taking a risk. Not gonna step on this because it's gonna make a sound.
That's a strange noise.
That didn't go as planned.
Die, you!
How do I pick up the body? Like this.
Your dog meat.
No, I'm dead.
There. Maybe I'll get a bonus for this.
Okay. Well, we don't really need to take him out with the blackjack. Although it's fun, admittedly. Let's try it again. Maybe it's gonna...
Hey, you over there!
I did that wrong. Let's try it again.
Boys?
Oh, that worked somehow. Where's the body? Oh, here. Solan, try to reload the page. I'm gonna take a look at what's going on, but I still see it here on my end. How do I drop the body now? Oh, I... See, Solan, watch it later. You can drop bodies here like this. The guard's just unconscious, by the way. Saw me. Is he gonna come down here all the way? If so, I'm prepared.
I've got you.
He saw me.
Too easy. After him.
More guards. I'm dead. Okay, well, did not go as planned once again. I better stay in the shadow. But this is a good spot for hiding bodies in general. Audio is pretty good, by the way. I think I'm gonna black check the other guard if I can manage to. I still have to figure out the best distance to actually do that. I need to be careful with surfaces I walk on.
You've got.
Nope, that didn't work. I need to learn the blackjack a little better. I'm just gonna sneak past them for now. So Len, if you try to watch it in the browser, sometimes it stops in the browser. Not sure if I'm hidden enough here.
It gets much worse if you only have to get pulled.
So Len, you missed me stacking up bodies in the side alley. Okay, this seems to be an okay place to stay hidden. Just don't know how to. Stay here, wait until the guard passes again, and then take this one that's just standing there out. Yeah, I love it that I can lean forward in this game. That's amazing. There he is. But it's dark enough here, as you can see in with that little gem in the front, that
there's the tavern. That guard in front is a problem. I'll either need to distract him or find another way in.
Okay. I haven't assigned the button for objectives. Find your way to Canterbury Tavern and get inside. Okay, search Lord Rothwick's room for the rubies. Find loot of at least 400. There's someone.
Swords would be like in a fight.
I heard those swords are just for show. They say the wolves can use magic to summon genies and wind and stuff.
What do they do,
huh? Can I peek through the...
And winds. They can summon really, really strong winds.
Oh, sure.
The door sounds so loud.
Sound.
That worked. Gonna close the door. Nice ragdoll physics here. Is there anything of value in here? Well, I need to know the code for this one. Book. Not sure. Gas arrow. It's like a rocket launcher, I heard. $50. Ha! That's why it's worth it, sneaking into people's places and knocking them out. Lord Bell happened to host the vizier. You gotta be careful about reading, because the time the game continues while you read. Okay, I don't think that's anything of significant interest. Anything here? Just wondering if there's a way that I can search his body. It doesn't happen to be 451, does it? Okay. How do I... How do I turn this one? It said so earlier, but I missed that one. Controls take a little getting used to, yeah. That's not what I meant to do. Oh, okay. Well, if it's 451, then that's a tattoo. On the nose. If you don't know why 451, then go look it up. Oh, is it maybe in here? Is there a code in here? 3 digits 272 is the only thing. Oh, I'll try 272. Maybe I can find it somewhere else later on. Is there another key for searching the body? Yeah, well, Fahrenheit 451 might play a role, but nobody knows that. It's in basically every immersive sim game. One of the first key codes is 0451 or 451. Which they say is because Looking Glass Studios had a key door code of 451 or 0451.
Saw it. Said it cured his gout.
I wonder if it will put the hospital out of business.
You mean Belhaven? It'd be out of business already if Lord Belhaven wasn't paying for the whole thing himself.
I wasn't expecting someone to show up from there.
I had given myself a good fright for nothing. Oh.
At least.
So, how's your shift?
Could be worse.
Is there any money here? I like the music. It's very befitting. Okay. Time to test the water arrow, I would say.
A one-eyed guard. This must be my lucky day.
So he does move about a little. Then he looks out the window. I would like to catch him when he looks out the window. You can see here at the bottom that I'm not very visible. He is wearing a helmet though, so I can't take him out all that easily. First, I want to take a look in this room actually. Wasn't expecting this. I thought he was gonna just stand in front of the door. I'll be back in just a moment. Yes, I will open that lock. Can I take care of this now? Where are my lockpicks? I thought it was this key. Did the keys change again on me here? Fit in here apparently, huh? I guess I need to find the key somewhere. I have a key from earlier. Where is it? There was someone sleeping. Okay, do they have the key on them? Electrification kills Doctor. Okay, the plague is here. Missing something. No money, nothing. I wonder if I can somehow peek through doors, but I doubt it. Must be thinking, yeah, someone left the door open. Let's try this again. Key doesn't work. Lockpick doesn't work, and the other lockpick also doesn't work. What the? Ah, well. Here. or something? Rafael, you? Probably not. Rothwick's journal. Can I read this? Soot and stench. I don't know, only thieves hide in the dark alleys, but they come out of the very sky. I was walking by a transmitter tower next to a tavern. That guy swooped on. Okay, well, it's supposed to be a safe neighborhood, but I saw two moors on the street outside last night. People seem to think they are that ambassador. These two look like they were up to no good. This man down the street, and they obviously didn't want him to know it. How am I supposed to feel secure with that kind of thing going on? Innkeeper has put my jewels in an iron safe in his room. He wouldn't tell me the combination when I asked what would happen to the contents. Oh, he forgot what it was. He just laughed and said when that happens, he goes and gets drunk at his workbench. What an odd fellow. So the innkeeper knows it. We don't know if the innkeeper has written it down somewhere. Must be the guy that I knocked out in the on the first floor. If it weren't for the trade fair of the inventor's guild, I wouldn't have believed Braden, but the devices they had on display were wondered to be lanterns that can follow behind you. Shame Bridgeport keeps these wonders for itself. All their blueprints are in code. Okay, search for the rubies. Get the rubies from the innkeeper's safe. Okay. I feel like I should save. Not just quick save. There's a ring that I wanted. Can I somehow turn off these lights without using a water arrow? If someone knows this, let me know. Action, crouch, attack, inventory. I take it with the right mouse button, then I do use item, which is enter key in my case. That way I can snuff out the candle. Oops, I didn't want to run. That might actually be an issue if I run too much and make too much noise. Nothing in here. Nothing up here. This one here opens, but nothing inside. No. Damn it. I need to be smarter about this. I'll leave that other door alone. It can stay open. Unfortunately, the cover of darkness is protecting me here. This right now, I'm running on my laptop, which is a Skylake laptop. Again, nothing. So it's the integrated Skylake GPU. Like HD 4530 or something. Nothing here either. Okay. This was a waste of time too. I don't know how to open the safe. That's the problem. I'll leave it at that. There's been plenty. And the game is kind of challenging, but it's fun. Very reminding of Thief, so I'm hoping to get this port ready soon. Wish I could get an updated version that fixes the issues with the newer AMD graphics cards. Yeah, you can keep an eye out, if you use OpenBSD, keep an eye out for this coming to ports on current. It should be probably ready by the time 6.6 comes out, sometime in fall, probably. And yeah, we hang out on OpenBSD-gaming on IRC. Freenode if you want to learn more. Thanks for watching.